Hi and welcome back to my channel. I'm going to be making more wax mounts today, but today I'm going to be using a solid wax. This is in a tub. It literally gets poured in there and it sets, and then you've got to break it up to get it out. It is harder than the pellets for that reason. As you can see, it is quite hard, so I use a sharp knife to break it up. This one is a Carasoy pillow wax. I've got so many different waxes upstairs, it's unbelievable. But yeah, I'm going to use that one today, which I've already measured out 100 grams. I'm going to be using these snap bar moulds. You literally get 5 segments in each bar, and then they just snap off a bit when you want to put it into your warmer. Everybody's doing these, so you've probably seen these. I'm going to use Snow Angel fragrance oil, which is a dupe of Lush. I'm going to use a liquid dye again. This one's teal. I'm going to put a little bit of silver glitter in the moulds. It's biodegradable glitter. And like I say, there's my 100 grams of wax, which I've got to melt down. I'm using 100 grams of wax, but this fragrance oil is pretty strong, so I think I'll only use 7 grams. So it's 100 grams of wax and 7 grams of fragrance. So yeah, I'll get the wax melted and put it on the pot. And there's the wax starting to melt. I'll just keep breaking it up. So obviously there's larger pieces in there as well as smaller pieces. Get in there. The first thing I'm going to do is sprinkle a little bit of glitter in a couple of these. This is silver. It's just the fine glitter. So it's biodegradable. Should be enough. Gives it a little bit of sparkle. And what I'm going to do is with the liquid dye, I'm going to put a drop into the mould, so when I pour the natural coloured wax onto it, it should make it different, not different colours, but it'll make it teal and cream. So I'll just drop a piece of that into one of the segments, and I can squeeze it. Oh, there we go. That's plenty. And wait for the wax to melt. I've got a thermometer in there now, keeping an eye on the temperature. See, it's a little bit more to melt. I'm going to wait till it gets up to about 80 degrees Celsius. The wax melted down. I'm just going to wait for the temperature to reduce, like I say, to about 67 before I add the fragrance oil. Alright, we are getting there. I usually tilt up the jug when I'm using this little wax, just because it gives you a better reading of the temperature. With it further up the stick. Yeah, we're nearly at the temperature, ready to add the fragrance oil. Right. Yep. I think that's ready. Every time I use my thermometer or spoon, when I take it out, I wipe it off with a bit of tissue, just to get the wax off, because else it will set solid on your spoon or your thermometer. So, right, we've just got to add the fragrance oil into the wax. And then we've got to give it a stir for at least 2 minutes to make sure the fragrance oil incorporates into the wax well. Oh, this is like a bubblegummy scent. So it's a dupe of one of Lush's fragrances. Just give it a good stir. Alexa, time 2 minutes.
2 minutes.
Got to put the timer on. Right, here we go. Let's see if this is successful. I haven't done it this way before. I usually mix a colour into the wax and to do different jugs, but I'm going to try just by putting the liquid dye into the mould and just pour like so. Them up to the top. I've kept it in one place because I didn't want the dye to mix around too much. Yeah. Once you finish pouring, make sure you wipe your jug out with a paper towel. Never pour any wax down your sink because it'll block your sink. But while the wax is still soft, wipe your jug out. There we have the two snack bars. I probably could have got away with just putting one drop of liquid dye in. I thought I'd put two just in case. And I kept pouring in the same place. I think if I'd poured up and down slightly, I would have filled up that edge more and it would have moved the dye around a bit more. But we'll have a look when they unmold. So I'll come back when they're ready. And here are the wax melts all hardened up. So you do the same, you just pull the mould away from the edges. That's come away quite quick. I left them overnight to harden up. And just push up from the bottom. Let's have a look. Ooh, actually that's turned out better than I thought. Still got a bit too much in the place where I dotted the dye. But I think if I pour a bit more in that spot, or from a higher distance, I suppose, it would spread it around a bit more. I don't know, it's pretty good. Let's see what that one turned out like. I've got a dot there. But all in all, they're pretty good. You can see a little bit of glitter. Give it a little bit of sparkle. All you do with these is just slap a bit off each time you want it. Just put it into your warmer and off you go. So there we are. Well, I hope you've enjoyed this video. If you have, please, if you could push the thumbs up for me, that would give me a like on my video. And if you'd like to see more of my videos, if you could subscribe to my channel, it's free to subscribe. Don't ask for any money. And if you push the notification bell, you'll get notified when any of my future videos get posted. So, like I say, I hope you enjoyed the video and I hope to see you again soon. I'll see you later. Bye.